have a digital laser scanner. This particular one is built by a company called Next Engine. And what it does is you can put a part of some kind in this, and it sends out a light signal, reflects that back. I've done a number of scans, and these have been knit together into the current information that I've collected on the model. And these really are just points in space. If I zoom in on this, there's all these little points in space, and the software goes through and can build a surface through those. This is a mesh that, if I zoom in, this is all connected with a mesh, and there's actually meshes laying on top of meshes because we have multiple scans going on here. And but then it will go through and ultimately put a surface across those, and that digital information, I can use other equipment to be able to replicate this. They're using a lot of this different technology for medical applications, for working with people that have had accidents of some kind and broken bones and limbs and everything, and they can actually take CAT scan information and create digital models of those broken bones and parts and plan out complete operations before they ever go into an operating room. A doctor can practice a whole procedure on a model if they need to do that. So there's just an unlimited amount of application for all this new technology, and it's basically keeping your mind open enough and selecting the pieces that you need to do what you want to do, or to try and apply it in a way that it's never been applied before. I was fortunate enough and honored to be presented an award this last fall through the Oregon Association of Career Technical Educators. The OATC, the Oregon OATC as they call it, gives out a number of different awards every year, and I was selected for the Leadership Award for the state of Oregon for 2014 by some of my constituents at both the community colleges and the local high schools, primarily for working with the instructors in dual credit and creating coursework and training instructors in dual credit coursework. So I was very honored for that, and I work with great people, and that's why I teach. My reaction was, it was a little bit funny because I had shown up to the conference ready to present an hour presentation, and I had walking pneumonia that week. But I did come to the award banquet under the encouragement of about three people, and I had no idea why. But when they started reading the background of the person, and they talked about this person has created six courses in advanced technology orientation that the also with a focus on trying to set up dual credit for the small labs being set up in local high schools that had no articulation plan. And basically they went on and on and on, and I was like, that could only be me, because there's nobody here that does that but me. So I was quite taken back, very, very surprised, and honored at the same time. And that's why I love coming to work here is, I get to work with my students, and I get to make a difference. I can train someone for a couple years and know that when I go to their graduation and I meet their family, that I've given them a skill that they can take care of their family for the rest of their life, and I can't get that from any other job.